Hi, I'm Alexandros Chiasos, and if you follow me on Instagram, you may have seen in my stories that I accidentally damaged the left crank arm of my Jitsie Varial trails bike. The left pedal got loose while I was riding, and by the time I noticed it, the threads were already damaged. Actually, my left pedal gets loose from time to time on both of my bikes, but I've no idea why. Maybe it's my riding style and the fact that I'm right foot forward, but I don't really know. Does this also happen to you? Please let me know in the comment section below. Anyway, having damaged the threads, I can go the easy way and just replace the crank arm with a new one, or I can make it more fun and fix it by making a threaded insert to replace the damaged threads. Actually, I've done it before for my old street trials bike and I had no issues after the repair until I bought the Spiral Arcade 2 years ago and stopped riding my old for play. Before we start, I have to tell you that you can also repair your crank arms by yourself, as there are commercially available threaded inserts and tabs so as to get the job done, or you can ask your mechanic to do it for you. However, I'm not going to use such inserts, as you may already know that I'm a mechanical engineer and my job is to design and manage the manufacturing of products. So I'm going to make everything from scratch, but first let's unmount the crank from the bottom bracket and remove the pedal. Okay, these threads have been really stripped. And frankly, I have to admit that after realizing that the threads have been damaged, I kept riding for a while because I knew that it was a game over for the threads, and also I knew that I can fix it. So I rode for a while after that, and I stopped because the pedal started to feel very unstable and dangerous to continue riding. However, in case you face a similar situation, please stop riding right away, as it may be quite dangerous. Next, let's make a 3D model of the part that I'm going to make, and to do that I'll use Fusion 360, which is a great 3D modeling and manufacturing software that I use every day for my actual job. So, knowing that the thread size for the pedal is 9/16 of an inch, which is a size over 14 mm, I'm going to make a threaded insert that will have an outer thread of 20 mm and an internal thread that will be suitable for the pedal thread. Both of these threads will be left hand threads, as it's the left crank arm that has been damaged. Also, I have to mention that I decided to go for a 20 mm outer thread so as to make it a little bit more heavy duty, as the commercially available threaded inserts have an outer thread of 5/8 of an inch, which, as you can see in the drawing, leaves about 0.16 mm of unthreaded wall thickness, and by choosing to have 20 mm outer thread, leaves about 2.22 mm of actual unthreaded wall thickness. Now, having already designed the threaded insert, it's time to program and manage its manufacturing. So, using Fusion 360, I programmed the actual toolpath that will give us the final threaded insert, and having everything ready, it's time to actually machine both the insert and the crank. Starting from the insert, I decided to make it using a milling machine and thread milling the thread so as to get tighter tolerances and eliminate the probability of getting loose ever again. The threaded insert is ready when the fit with the pedal feels just about right according to my feeling and experience. Now it's time to machine and rethread the crank arm so as to actually fit the threaded insert. So I fixed the crank arm on the vise of the milling machine and I thread milled the threads so as to get the fit I want when I thread the insert of the crank arm. Finally, everything is ready to get assembled again, but first we have to fix the insert on the crank arm. To do that, I use the red thread locking compound, which is considered to be permanent. In order to thread the insert to the crank arm, I cleaned everything with acetone so as to remove any contaminants and ensure that the thread locking compound will work as specified. Having secured the insert to the crank arm, it has to be left for about 24 hours until the thread locking compound cures and fixes everything in place. After that, it's time to properly assemble the crank arm and the pedal on my bike. Now that is everything okay and well tightened, my Jitsie Varial is again ready for some bike trials action. After riding my bike for a couple of hours since I repaired it, I am very happy as my crank arm feels as good as new. However, this is only a temporary solution and I really have to schedule its replacement the next time I order parts for my bike. Okay, that's it for today and I hope that you like the repair of my left crank arm. What do you think about the end result? Please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, smash the like button, and in case that you are new to the channel, subscribe and hit the notification bell so as to get notified every time I upload a new video. Finally, we can always be in touch by following me on social media. You can find the links to the relevant accounts in the description below. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Until then, make sure that your bikes are well maintained.